So welcome, today we're going to talk about skill shifting. I think this is one of the most important skills to have as a systems thinker or also just a person in general. So imagine you want to eat a snack and you think about the effects of it. So there are temporal effects on a small skill, you might become very happy in a few seconds, but over the days you might feel a bit guilty, and over the years you might become fed of it. So this might be influencing your decision to eat it. But also on the spatial skills, there are effects. So it has effects on the microbes, on your body, on the social sphere, what do your friends say about it, and on the world, where does it produce and what is the effects of the plastic of it. So although you're thinking about these different skills, they all happen and it's all nested at the same time. So they eating a snack has both the short-term and long-term effects in time and in space. Well, time and space are connected to each other, but let's get into it now. Because we as humans are not so good at seeing all these skills at the same time, because if you would, for example, look at this painting, you might focus one time on the details and then you zoom out again and look at the bigger picture, zoom in again and look at the smaller details. So that's also what we kind of usually do. We usually settle on one scale or level of aggregation and then focus on that. So are there people who are focusing on really on microbes, chemistry and pleasure and feelingness, while other people are more focusing on larger skills like ecosystems, evolution, on these different parts of different skills on different levels. But as a systems thinker, you want to look at the world holistically and connect them together. So you have to switch between these skills on the temporal and on the spatial skill. So you have to switch from looking at the big picture stuff to looking at the tiny little details. And you can look at those at levels from different scales. I usually like to think of it more as this fractal kind of tree, where you consider that it's all connected and everything influencing each other. So if you change a small thing, you also change a thing in a larger scale. So to make a connection between it. So when you start to think like this, you can also ask questions about it to change your skill perception. And a few of these questions are like, when you zoom into the tree, you might like, what's the purpose of this? And what are the parts that are making it? And what is happening at right now to the end of actually doing it at this very moment. So you can really zoom into an issue and you can also zoom out to an issue. So, well, what are different ways? What is all affected by doing this? And why are we doing it? So you can zoom in and zoom out and ask different questions in certain situations. Well, there are many more interesting things to discuss, but I think we don't really get into that now. So like a tuning to the right moment. So what do you need? Which skill is necessary at this moment? Do we need to focus on the details or do we need to look at the whole picture? And that's also related to the coherence of this across the skills. If you know your purpose, you know what to do. So then the small skills are attuned to the large skills. And well, there are also various personal tendencies to focus on the small skills and the large skills, but we also won't really get into that. So for now, I just want to thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you want to read more about these theory, or if you're interested in these drawings that I showed here, you can go to my website, justintimmer.com. If you are more interested in having workshops or lectures about this kind of stuff, about skills for systems thinkers, you can go to my website. Well, the picture's in Dutch, but if you go to your website, it's also in English. But for now, I just want to thank you all for watching and see you next time.